Heartly afternoon to all the guests present over here. I am Vishal Khatnani from G.H. Raisoni College of Commerce, Science and Technology. It's my pleasure welcoming you all in the fifth session of Orange City Literature Fest Edition 2, Day 2 by SGR Knowledge Foundation. It's the fifth session of Orange City Literature Fest and this session will be of 40 minutes. We will be now having a panel discussion on rape of a rape case with Mr. Naveen Chaudhary. Naveen Chaudhary, sir, is an author and starist. His political thriller, Janta Store, is soon going to be adapted as a web series. He works as Associate Marketing Director at Oxford University Press and leads social science discipline marketing globally. Mr. Anuj Tiwari, sir, a TEDx speaker and marketing consultant settled in Mumbai. Anuj Tiwari, sir, was brought up on the bustling street of Bareilly. Despite going through 6 months of depression and severe anxiety and trying to give up on his life in college, he is now best-selling author of 5 books inspired by real-life incident. He has also been listed as one of the top 10 most influential authors in India from 2016. Miss Vinay Nalwa, ma'am. Miss Vinay Nalwa, ma'am, is an author and columnist. She has master's degree in social work and a PhD in sociology. She has worked extensively on gender-specific mental health issue also. She has written extensively on various socio-political issues and major media platforms. She has co-authored the book Ram Janmabhoomi, Truth, Evidence, Faith. Her forthcoming book is on Inquisition and Liberation of Goa. She is a senior fellow with Delhi-based think tank Vichar Vinmay Kendra. In conversation with Samanthak Badra, sir. Samanthak Badra, sir's poem and review have been published in magazines, although like anthologies like Rain Taxi, The Missing State, Not Magazine, and Taj Mahal Reviews, among others. He is a TEDx speaker and a Millennium Fellow and has worked in sales, marketing, and CSR roles with Titan Company before joining Manjul Publishing House as the head of marketing and promotion. Currently, he runs his own branding, marketing, and art consulting company called The Sound, through which he helps authors and publishers market their books. Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much, Vishal, for the warm introductions. I welcome Naveen, Vinay, and Anuj, stalwarts in this space, veterans rather, and I'm extremely honored and delighted to be in conversation with the three of you. Thank you so much for taking your time out to be part of this session. And as we all know today, I am particularly, delighted, and I feel I'm lucky to have a wonderful Sunday afternoon of all days, to join such an august company to discuss something that's, of course, been talked about a lot, but probably needs to be talked about a lot more, because media trials as a phenomenon, as a phrase, is not only sensitive, but, there are very many divided camps in the space. And, there are way too many examples, there are way too many debates, there's way too much noise about this phenomenon. And probably today, through our conversation, given the very colorful experiences and lived experiences that you have had, in your interactions, in your personal spaces, it would be lovely to see how we can maybe look at this phenomenon called media trials, what happened with, from the latest phenomenon of, Riya Chakrabarti's, the much oft talked about malignment of Riya Chakrabarti, from there to, the more well-known and more historically well-known cases of that of O.J. Simpson and everything in between, not much has changed since then, right? And it would be lovely to probably have your opinions, probably have a conversation and probably understand why we are where we are today in terms of media trials as a phenomenon too. So without further ado, I'd love to probably, open our discussion today with the question of, do you probably think that media trials, and please feel free to answer whoever wishes to, do you feel media trials as a phenomenon has become more frequent and probably more vicious in the current times as opposed to maybe back in the day?
Can I start?
Sure.
I worked and started my career in media, and it was with newspapers. So I spent 6 years in media, and then I moved to another industry. So some of that experience, and as a viewer, as a reader, the way I see things, the media, which was always considered as voice of people, that's really started turning into product. And this is something which started happening in the early 2000s when things started changing. And everything became a product. News became a product. It became market. So the revenue, the audience, TRP, these things, that became so much important that any media house, they start getting more viewership, more audience. So news is not a news right now. It is sensation. It is an opportunity. And like when today's topic, which we are talking about, the rape of a rape case, so talking about rape, especially in the last 4 or 5 years, we have seen a lot of media trials on these cases, be it Unnao case for Sanger, if we talk about the Kathua case. Things though got divided into political ideology, but media was someone that could have put it on track. But media also supported and fueling different ideologies as per media's ideology, and they supported different sides, and it made it something else. What I have felt that rape, which is a crime, is not seen as a crime by media and not by politicians as well. So they see it as an opportunity to sensationalize, to get more viewership and talk to some kind of politics around it. And unfortunately, media is supporting the politicians to that. That is happening very much. So that is something which started changing things a lot. And not just rape cases, so that is our topic, but as you mentioned about Riya Chakravarti, even in that case, if you see, the major point was drugs case, but it all started moving about the ganja, the mal, which we are talking about. Anybody who's working into media industry or into film industry knows how easily this is available. But other drugs, which are more damaging, which are like available illegally, the discussion actually moved from that. So somewhere if you see, the discussion started from drugs and started moving towards just one point. And what I feel, as a viewer, I feel it was not about drugs. It was somewhere there's a cartel which tried to push the focus from other drugs like heroin or cocaine and everything that started moving towards ganja. So there are so many different parties who are somewhere pushing to the media houses. Media also that is looking for products. So everyone's vested interest that is coming together, and this media trial is increasing on each and every topic. So this is what I am looking for initially, and once Vinay and Anuj will share their points, maybe they come up. So this is what I wanted to start with.
Thank you so much. Yeah. That's a very interesting opening statement.
Yeah, I think I'll move more in direction of what Naveen ji has said. Media trial goes wrong when they draw their own understanding of notion of victimhood. As it happens in Riya Chakravarti's case, instead of focusing on the real issue, the issue turned towards the character of a person, and it's sort of vilifying the person, and the menace, the drug menace, it took a backseat. And then suddenly all the Bollywood celebrities, they were all vilified turn by turn. And the second thing is, I think the credibility of the victim also takes a center stage when with the preconceived notion when media trial moves. If they are endorsing a particular view, if they are endorsing a particular, the portrayal of, the motivation or the portrayal of a victim, it becomes so overbearing that the rest of the issue, the main issue, it gets somehow diluted. So that's why I think a media trial if it is done in a manner which how it started, that it has to be based on facts, it has to be based on sense rather than sensationalism. So it has lost that thing, you know, that sensitivity or the thin line that is lost. I think Anuj might elaborate more on
it. Yeah. So we talked about the problem, as Naveenji said, and we talked about, you know, a bit of conclusion that you said, Vinayji. So I think the whole picture, what I understand is, you know, in our country right now, because everything has its peak. And as Naveenji said that, you know, everything is a product these days, right? And it's very true. It's very true. But the whole picture is like in our country, what is happening right now is that, you know, our media, whether it's called print media or it's like news channels, they have taken the decision before our lower court, Supreme Court, High Court, they did take it. So, right. So they are victimizing the person. They are deciding who is the victim, who is the criminal before our courts are deciding. So that is one of the, you know, I would say worst thing happening in our country. And somehow this is encouraging people, because everybody is not so intelligent called in our country, right? So people are, this is actually damaging the mentality we all have in our country. And if we look at the, you know, top view of, you know, the situation in our country right now, that is not very good, that I feel. But everything has its peak, and it's our responsibility as a viewer. We all have the responsibility that how we look at the things. If you ask me when was the last time I watched television, I think I don't remember that. Probably a month ago. Because people have left that faith of looking at, you know, news channels or print media or whatever you call it. Because now slowly and gradually they have started realizing that whatever they are watching might be not true. And I have lost my faith from print media or news channels. So I think I'm assuming that there are crores of people in our country thinking the same thing.
Very interesting. I mean, if you would allow me to put in a prompt, like impromptu sort of a question here, does therefore the onus really lie with the masses to educate themselves? Of course it does. I'm not questioning that. But relatively speaking, isn't there a higher degree of responsibility with the media, with the governing institutions? You know, although there is a responsibility on the masses, should we not hold accountable, the powers that be? I mean, both in the media space, in the political space, and so on and so forth, right? What do you think about that?
I would like to take that. So first thing first, they have not left any option to take the responsibility, because if they would have ever taken that, they would not show these things that we are seeing on the news channels. Second thing, what could be the solution? That government should take proper action. But unfortunately, end of the day, there are some things, endorsements are done, promotions are done, which are in favor of certain political parties. So even in that note, they cannot make any restriction, they cannot make any policies around that. So I think, unfortunately, I see a complete gray area, and I don't think so there is any solution, and there is anybody who is going to take the responsibility. There may be authorities, higher authorities, who can, you know, make some policies someday. I'm just hoping that. But I think others can share what they think about it.
I have a quote observation.
Naveenji. Yes, Naveen, can you hear us?
Gray area. That's gray. Yeah, can you hear me now? Yeah, okay. So that gray area is actually very tricky. There are regulations. It's not that there are not regulations. For the websites, digital medium, it is less. But for the news channels and for newspapers, it is. Like, you cannot name a victim. If in a rape case, you cannot name a victim.
But Naveenji, sorry to cut you. But there are many, there are situations when people are actually talking about everything. And we know that. We show the backpiper or any alcohol brand, but we show the water bottle. And we are not, I mean, the whole population in a country, they are not fools. So they know that what they are branding. So, I mean, there may be policies, but there are loopholes that our media, you know, using that very trickily. Yeah, so. Please go ahead.
Yeah. So why that happens? There is a debate between freedom of media and the policy. Now, this is something which is, I think, not very much defined. The gray area which you find, if there is a name, so no action has been taken if any media mention name of a rape victim. If you will not take action, someone else will do. So that is something which happened in past in some cases. Other area is the freedom of media, freedom of press, and the regulation. I think there is no clear defined line, and that is somewhere the media houses play a lot with the rule. And the governments are scared that sometimes they will be accused for cutting the freedom of press. And media is actually playing with that. That is something which actually creates a gray area. And I'm not sure that how that can be defined very clearly, what is freedom of press and how it should not be. But I don't think it is too difficult also. Few things which I feel, name is something which was definitely part of it, where you don't mention the name. Second thing is, if somebody is, let's take again Riya Chakravarti's case. So the way media crews followed her, the way she was like, she's having a human rights. So that is something which need to be taken care of. Is a media taking her bite? Are they taking her point of view? Which is in a news, when you write, you always take both point of views. So if there is a case, police point of view. Another point is Riya Chakravarti's point of view. So are you taking a point of view? Who are you following her? Oh, now she is in the car. Oh, she's having a red lipstick on. She's wearing this, that. So this is something which somewhere need to be cut down. This is not freedom of press. This is, unfortunately, they are hitting on the human right of anybody. It can happen with anybody. So that clear definition is between freedom of press and regulation. Media definitely don't want, and I think government is also not trying to put that clear definition. If that is there, then somewhere we will be able to manage this kind of situation. Not 100%, but yes, somewhere it will be possible. Vinaji wanted to.
Yes. I think I would like to talk about what court has observed. I think I'll be quoting from one court observation. It says, it appears that there is no mechanism of enforcement and implementation of statutory provisions and guidelines. And adding to that, it has been said that in the absence of any mechanism, it is possible that there could be some person who is not involved in a case be mistakenly made and accused by the media. So this sort of discrepancy can also is also observed by the court, that the person who is not involved, that can also be has to go through the torture. So effort should be made to fix accountability of the media, and to that the court has stated that the state governments, they should make it a police commissioner should have one officer whose duty will be to see to that where there is a defamation due to media trial, or there is some sort of vilification of a person in due to media trial. So that can be, taken care of, so that any person who's facing the repercussions of this malaise can, be addressed through a single point person, and it can be taken care of. So the courts are already observing, and in number of cases, they have intervened also. And I think which has actually helped in taking care of this.
Pradupin, I'd actually like to quickly jump in here. Now that we're talking about the courts, right? We've been talking about the other institutions, but it is also a known fact that according to the Indian law, trial by media, trial, a parallel trial, so to say, by the media, if proven and upheld, can be construed and can lead to contempt of court, right? Do you think, given that there's a proper provision for something like this, a direct causality, trial by media, therefore contempt of court. Do you think that the Supreme Court and the high courts probably, you know, could play a more stringent role in such cases than they have done in the current past and in the past, essentially, right? Do you think that the courts could probably become a little more strict, or any thoughts in that space?
I think there is an IPC section 228A, which deals with the disclosure of the identity of the victims. So that is helpful. And apart from that, court has observed that there are regulatory bodies, which are mainly, I think, the suggestive kind. They can, they can suggest the agencies to handle such if they are breaching the space, they can, they are of suggestive kind, but there is no agency which can control actually what is happening, and they can, there is मतलब कुछ ये नहीं है कि कुछ ऑर्डर या कुछ ऐसी जो पूरा ओवरलुक करे, पूरा मीडिया को देखे, गाइड करे और डायरेक्शन दे. तो दैट इज एक्चुअली लैकिंग. बट कोर्ट सेड इट हैज टू बी डन बाय मीडिया की जो एजेंसीज हैं, बी इट द प्रेस काउंसिल, बी इट द ब्रॉडकास्ट गिल्ड हैं जो वो कर सकती हैं, एंड देयर इज वन, देयर आर मेनी. नवीन जी विल बी एबल टू,
आई प्रोबब्ली आस्क नवीन एंड अनुज हियर, आई मीन एज एंसिलरी टू दिस पॉइंट, इज लाइक कैन द कोर्ट्स बी अ लिटिल मोर, आई मीन इफ आई हैव एट द रिस्क ऑफ यूजिंग द वर्ड प्रोएक्टिव.
द कोर्ट्स एंड द डिसीजन व्हिच विनय जी ऑलरेडी शेयर्ड, देयर आर रूल्स व्हिच वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट. The biggest point I challenge I see is with the implementation, which I was trying to say in the previous point also. If you, I don't know how many of you remember, a few years back, a media channel, they portrayed a school teacher in Delhi as someone who is sending her students into flesh trade, into prostitution. They covered it. It was not a police case. They covered it. They made it sensation. It was 2-3 days sensation. Police filed the case, and that teacher's life was ruined. So in her society, people actually attacked her house. So many things happened that media channel covered it. And after 3 or 4 days, we got to know in police investigation that that entire thing was false. Something else was happening. She was sending the students somewhere else and preparing for that. And it was some acts she was preparing. And they just shoot it and present it in the wrong way. That lady's life got ruined. She left from that house in this wherever she was staying. I don't know if her job is still there or not. So it was a government job, so I think she must be there. But life is ruined. That news channel is still there. That news channel is still running such kind of stories. So these are the things which are still happening. So an agency, some agency which can actually look at it, which can actually implement the things. There must be something for advertisement. If you see, for advertisements, you can actually write a complaint to, I forgot the name of agency. You can write a complaint about any advertisement if you think that advertisement is false or claiming anything false. So you can write to them and then an action can be taken. Red FM, radio mein thoda sa ye hua, if you remember, there was very famous RJ Nitin. So when he was in Red FM, he said something defamatory about Nepali people. और रेड एफएम को 2 दिन ऑफ एयर कर दिया गया था. दैट वाज द एक्शन. दैट इज समथिंग व्हिच समवेयर कंट्रोल्स द मीडिया. दैट इज समथिंग व्हिच समवन सेज टेक एन एक्शन, देन इट विल बी कंट्रोल्ड. अनफॉर्चूनेटली देयर इज नो एजेंसी, और इफ देयर इज एन एजेंसी, दे आर नॉट डूइंग एनीथिंग. अनुज, यू वांटेड टू ऐड समथिंग.
सो आई थिंक एज व्हाट नवीन सेड इज वेरी वेरी ट्रू एंड वेरी करेक्ट. बट द प्रॉब्लम वी सी दैट, फॉर एग्जांपल द रेडियो व्हिच वेंट ऑफ फॉर 2 डेज, जो तो उन 2 दिनों में जो हुआ है, राइट, या फिर जो न्यूज चैनल्स ने दिखा दिया और हमने जो एक्शन लिए, तो जिस ड्यूरेशन में जो हम लोगों ने न्यूज दिखा दी है, उसका जो इम्पैक्ट है 130 करोड़ लोगों पे, वो एक प्रॉब्लम है. बिकॉज आप किसी का, अब जस्ट जस्ट यू नो एग्जाम्पल, आप किसी का मर्डर कर देते हो, राइट, तो वो तो मर्डरर हो गया, अब उसको आप सजा दे दोगे, वो तो सिर्फ एक एग्जाम्पल है बाकियों के लिए कि वो ऐसा ना करें। तो ये जो मर्डर हो रहे हैं, ये जो क्राइम हो रहा है, न्यूज चैनल से हो रहा है या प्रिंट मीडिया के थ्रू हो रहा है या जो हम लोग सोशल मीडिया पे देख रहे हैं, वो प्रॉब्लम है। तो प्रॉब्लम को कितना जल्दी हम लोग रेक्टिफाई करते हैं, आई थिंक वही सोल्यूशन हो सकता है। कुछ तरीके हैं कि शायद हम उनको दो घंटे में रेक्टिफाई कर दें, कुछ हो गया कि कोर्टरेट हो गया, हमको एक घंटे में सॉल्व करना है, विच इज वेरी अनफॉर्चुनेट, जो हमारी कंट्री में नहीं होता है। जो फास्ट ट्रैक भी होता है वो शायद महीनों का होता है, राइट? सो वो जो गलतियां हो रही हैं उस ड्यूरेशन में, वो ड्यूरेशन कितना लंबा है और उसका इम्पैक्ट कितना है, वो एक प्रॉब्लम है। आप रेक्टिफाई कोर्ट में केसेस तो सॉल्व होते ही हैं। मेरी खुद की सिस्टर का जो केस है वो आई थिंक पिछले 3 या 4 साल से चल रहा है। आप बिलीव नहीं करोगे, उसकी चार्जशीट कोर्ट में जाने के लिए 3 साल लगे हैं। एक छोटा सा केस है, हमारे लिए तो बहुत बड़ा है, लेकिन शायद पूरे देश के लिए बहुत छोटा सा केस होता है, राइट? तो वो मुझे पता है कि क्या उसकी प्रॉब्लम है ना? आप ग्राउंड रियलिटी तब जानते हो बिकॉज आप फेस करते हो। हम लोग बातें कर सकते हैं, बहुत सारी चीजें डिस्कस करते हैं, सॉल्यूशन ढूंढ सकते हैं, लेकिन जो विक्टम्स हैं या जो चीजें फेस कर रहे हैं वो तो ठीक है, चलिए एक साइड में रखते हैं, लेकिन जो उसका इम्पैक्ट है, अब आप मुझसे पूछोगे आपका कितना विश्वास है लॉज एंड ऑर्डर्स में, तो मुझे शायद बोलने में संकोच होगा कि मैं पूरी तरीके से अपने लॉज एंड ऑर्डर पर भरोसा करता हूँ या नहीं, बिकॉज मैंने वो फेस किया, मेरी फैमिली ने फेस किया हुआ। तो वो जो उसका इम्पैक्ट है, मुझे छोड़ के जो बाकी 130 करोड़ लोगों पे है, उसका जो इम्पैक्ट है वो कितना बड़ा और कितना इम्पैक्ट है उसका, उसको अगर हम कम कर सके वही एक सोल्यूशन होगा। आप उसको एलिमिनेट तो नहीं कर सकते, आप उसको कंप्रेस कर सकते हैं, सप्रेस कर सकते हैं, आप उसको एलिमिनेट कर सकते हैं, बस उस तरीके से।
वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग। आई मीन रियली आई वुड देयरफॉर वांट टू आस्क द फॉलो अप क्वेश्चन टू दिस। डू यू थिंक देयरफॉर देयर इज एनफ दिस माइट यूज द वर्ड रैम्पेंट सेक्सिज्म व्हेन इट कम्स टू मीडिया ट्रायल्स?
It is. I think it is. It is there. I don't remember quickly any examples, but it is visible. You can see that very much.
Is there a chance, essentially, that a female would be more easily maligned? I mean, as opposed to a male. I mean. Of course, we've seen the other situation much more. But I'm not just talking about. I'm talking about sexism not as a silo. Sexism as a part of a systemic problem. And other domino effects that are part of this whole piece.
I think a systematic disparity is there, as fewer women occupy positions of power in media organizations.
Very interesting.
Naveen ji, if you can.
Yeah, so I was just adding, it is very much visible everywhere, even in the cases in the organization, as Vinay just said. So, very recent example, we have Riya Chakravarti. She is not the only one who was named for you. So she got, of course, targeted due to the Sushant Singh. But once after that, we started talking about the drugs cases. There are so many stars who were named. So you remember Deepika Padukone, who was questioned. But do you remember any other male actors who were actually called for that? So the media's focus was there. That is something which is very much there. And also, as Vinay was pointing out, that she didn't complete it and given it to me. But I assume that she wanted to say it is the where women are on the position in media. That is also something which is not there. Vinay, maybe you were saying something else, so you can add on that. But this is my observation. In the media houses, it is also difficult. Not just media, everywhere. It is difficult for women to reach to the higher position. And that gender inequality in the organizations, in the corporates, is also something which is supporting this kind of thought process. When a woman is there, the idea gets changed. I work in a publishing house, and we have a lot of women in our organization. There are many. But then it is defined. In editorial, you'll find them. In marketing, you may find them, in creative side. But in sales, they are not. In production, they are not. So that is happening. Still, what I feel, the women which we have in editorial and marketing, due to their number, there is some sensitivity has been increased. Even if you ask me, I feel I was always sensitive, but in times I learned what sexism is. A lot of things which we just say in a joke, we think about halka phulka aise keh diya kuch bhi, but when you start working with them, you actually realize who they are as a human being, and then the difference actually start coming up. So there are many things. Somewhere, yes, the main question, which was, there is sexism, it is very much there. Vinay, sorry, I spoke in between. So
absolutely.
No, but you are right. You're absolutely right.
I agree, yeah.
Anuj, any thoughts on that? I mean, would love to know from a lived experience even, in case you want.
I have said enough. I think I agree with both of you.
Absolutely. So this is why, you know, because even Navinji had talked about the lady's case. And, you know, so I thought it would be a good time to actually address or see if there's any separate, you know, angle that might come from that. But also having said that, you know, I would probably have two follow-up questions. One is, you know, the rate of digitization that we've seen across the masses in the country, right? You know, the rate of adoption of screens, you know, print was always there. That's why we call it mainstream traditional media. But then, you know, the digital, the new age media, the adoption rate has been stupendously high. Would we therefore say that, you know, that policy making or, you know, a sort of flexibility in the, you know, in the policymakers, of not having been able to keep up with this rampant adoption, with this fast adoption of digitization across the masses, has led to probably an unchecked deluge of news, correct or fake, right? And is that probably at the core of it? Because, you know, Anuj, you had initially said that, you know, as the masses, we need to educate ourselves. No one's going to educate us for ourselves. We need to kind of get going on that. But even before we get to that stage, at the very initial stage itself, for the masses who've not even had the 101 education or awareness or information spread of what's correct and what's not, I think for me, that's the root cause of a lot of things that's happening today as a domino effect, you know, and that's what the media trials actually, you know, piggyback on, you know, they piggyback on that weakness. So what would your thoughts be on that?
As I said, I mean, many things are happening. Whether we talk about any stream, whether it's online or, you know, traditional print media or news channels, I think as Naveen ji said initially, that it's very tricky also, right? So you cannot resolve it at that point of time. But as I said, that how frequent you can resolve confusion, I would say, rather than, you know, policies are being made, actions are being taken by government, or if we talk about like Facebook or Instagram or Google, so they are being serious on that note. They are taking actions, but I think we are still in progress stage right now. So I'm just hoping that things will be, I can just hope and dream of it, that things will be fine one day, and we would be a great, great world to live.
Dr. Vinay, any thoughts?
Well, I think if media can, take care of very small things, be it social media, be it television and other sources, if it can, focus on showing less coverage of violence, if violence can be devoid, and especially when carry it with some myths and assumptions, if it can take care of that, and especially related to victim, if we talk about the rape victims. Because as I think you all must have read about Arushi Hemraj murder case, and how her character, as well as the character of her parents and everything, it got so ugly. The violence, how it happened, how it must have happened. So that was the worst side, when you blame the victim, or when you judge on the character of the victim. So if we can, that's why the coverage of violence, and based on the myths and the assumptions of the media, the editor or whoever is responsible on the seat, and it should not, the focus, focus should be the subjects like if we are talking about drugs, then it should remain on the issue, the problem. The focus should be on problem rather than on the person. And I think these two things can, you know, bring back the dignity of the media, and it will be a good way to move forward if it can self-regulate itself, because we all media is also part of the society, part of us, and the people there, they are part of our this thing. So I think self-regulation should be there.
I remember a story. This is the very beginning of my career, and when media self-regulation, I was based in Delhi working with a newspaper, and that was my very first job at 6-7 months. Ek news thi kisi activist ke supporter ka murder ho gaya tha, aur uski follow-up news thi. So a lot of dirty things happened in media. So it was somewhere that kind of story. Uske andar, that activist, I was working media campaign with that activist, so he reached to me, ye issue ho raha hai aur aapke news ne kuch galat tarike se isko cover kiya hai. So what my newspaper, the newspaper I was working with, unhone ek photo click ki thi kisi aadmi ki jo ek form bharte hue paise le raha tha, aur wo paise lete hue ye tha ki ration card banwane ke liye aise kuch agent baith gaye ration card office ke bahar aur uski paise liye jaate hain. The fact was that guy was a RTI activist, aur wo jo hai RTI form bharne ka jo fees rakhta hai 10 rupaye 15 रुपए था, वो पैसे ले रहा था. उस फोटो को उन्होंने लेके पब्लिश कर दिया, मेरा रिपोर्टर ने. माय रिपोर्टर वाज एट फॉल्ट. अब चूंकि इशू मेरे थ्रू गया था, आई स्पोक टू द एडिटर, आई टोल्ड हिम द होल सीन. ही कॉल्ड दैट रिपोर्टर. उन्होंने उस रिपोर्टर से ये पूछा कि जिस आदमी ने पैसे दिए, क्या आपने उससे पूछा था कि वो पैसे किस बात के दे रहा है? रिपोर्टर ने कहा नहीं. तो जब आदमी पैसे ले रहा था, क्या आपने उससे पूछा कि ये कैसे किस बात के पैसे दे रहा है? कहा नहीं. क्या आपने चेक किया कि उस फॉर्म में क्या लिखा जा रहा है? नहीं. सो ऑल आंसर्स वर नो. दैट रिपोर्टर वाज फायर्ड, एंड नेक्स्ट डे द एडिटर पब्लिश्ड अपोलॉजी, एंड दैट इज समथिंग व्हिच आई सॉ विद इन 6 इयर्स. आई सॉ मिसिंग इन द न्यूज हाउसेस, न्यूज़पेपर्स के अंदर, कि वो रिस्पांसिबिलिटी लेनी है या एडिटर व्हिच टेकिंग रिस्पांसिबिलिटी, कि अच्छा ये हम लोगों ने गलती हो गई हमारे से, उसको बताएं, और अपने एडिटर्स को ये एजुकेट करना कि भैया ये तरीका है. आप सब एक न्यूज को पब्लिश कर रहे हैं, यू नीड टू वेरीफाई, यू नीड टू एंश्योर. वो जो चीज है कहीं ना कहीं मिसिंग है, व्हिच विनय जी आल्सो सेड, वो सर रेगुलेशन लाना बहुत जरूरी है.
देयर इज वन मोर थिंग. एक चीज और है, आई वांट टू इंटरजेक्ट. एक sure. कोई न्यूज आती है, कोई न्यूज बनती है, कोई सिचुएशन बनती है, उसका आप फर्स्ट डे अगर उसमें समथिंग रॉन्ग इज देयर, मतलब इट्स नॉट कुछ करेक्ट इनकरेक्ट इंफॉर्मेशन है, तो the amount of you know the attention it catches, and next day if you go for the कि नहीं correction है, वो चीज गलत हुई थी, गलत report किया गया था, actual was this situation, so second day you might not get all yes. those you know people who were there. तो वो एक opinion already formed हो चुकी होती है, और हम लोगों में as a masses, like जैसे अनुज जी ने बताया, हम लोग उस टाइम थोड़ा इर्रेस्पॉन्सिबल हो जाते हैं, क्योंकि हम उसे नेक्स्ट डे जब उसका करेक्शन आता है या उसका वो आता है, तो हम नहीं उस पे ध्यान देते.
So, अभी जो ये सारी जो प्रॉब्लम है, उसका मुझे ये लगता है कि वो प्रॉब्लम किस वजह से, वो ये है कि हर कोई न्यूज चैनल जो है वो ब्रेकिंग न्यूज दिखाना चाह रहा है, राइट? जैसा नवीन जी ने बोला कि बहुत बहुत मुश्किल चीजें नहीं है कि आप एक चेकलिस्ट बना के सिर्फ ये चेक करें कि क्या क्या चीजें हुई हैं और क्या क्या नहीं हुई हैं, और उसके बाद आप कंक्लूजन पे आ जाएंगे कि वो न्यूज आपको टीवी पर दिखानी है या नहीं. बहुत बहुत सिंपल तरीका, मुझे ऐसा लगता है. मैं भी एक टेक्निकल बैकग्राउंड से आता हूँ, मुझे लगता है कुछ इतना इससे ज्यादा शायद डिफिकल्टीज अदर चीजों में होती है. तो कुछ बहुत कठिन चीज नहीं है, लेकिन प्रॉब्लम ये है कि मैं पहले दिखाऊं, राइट? मुझे पहले दिखाना है, मुझे पहले बोलना है, तो वो प्रॉब्लम है. चाहे आप रिलेशनशिप ले लो या कुछ भी ले लो, हर कोई जो आज के जीवन में है वो सिर्फ सुनने से पहले बोलना चाहता है.
अनुज, I'll pop little bit, sorry. We have run out of time, but I do have two interesting questions to close off. If you guys could give us maybe one liner responses on those, and with that we'll close off the conversation. One is a question from the audience and one is a final question from my end. Probably if you could just, you know, take like 10 seconds each to kind of quickly respond and close. One is, you know, on the other hand, we see that there is a rising trend of powerful men seeking gag orders on sexual harassment cases. You know, we've been seeing that. And in fact, you know, there are activist groups that have been rising about this. They've been talking about the rise of such cases. You know, there are politicians, there are corporate leaders, and there's multiple examples. This year, there was a, you know, there was a case in Kerala, so on and so forth. So what do you think? That's exactly the opposite of a media trial, but it's equally harmful. So that's one point. And a question from the audience where they say that, you know, somebody's asked that, how do we identify which rape cases are true? You know, what's fake and what's not? You know, because some are agenda driven. So, you know, it's a very sensitive question. So would love to probably get 5 to 10 seconds of quick responses on those.
I will quickly answer the audience question. You just need to follow the facts. Just don't go by the fantasies. In each news, even in a fake news, if you read the news properly and just apply your mind, you will quickly realize what is fake, what is not. Case can be fake, but just follow the facts. Follow the investigation. That's it. You don't have to do anything.
Thank you. Vinay, Anuj.
So for the second question, as just add to Naveen's point. So भैया देखो दुनिया में बहुत सारे क्राइम हो रहे हैं. आप अपना देखो, अपने फैमिली का देखो. पहली चीज तो ये, क्योंकि आपकी फैमिली में बहुत सारे ऐसे लोग भी होंगे जो शायद आप इन्फ्लुएंस नहीं होंगे लेकिन वो हो जाएंगे. तो आपकी पहली प्राथमिक जो है रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी वो ये है कि आप अपना और अपने परिवार का देखें. उसके बाद अगर आप में हिम्मत है तो आप सोसाइटी में वो चीज स्प्रेड करें कि ये गलत है और ये सही है. अगर आपको कॉन्फिडेंस है कि आप सही है तो बाकी का आप कोर्ट पर छोड़ दें. बाकी का आई थिंक हम सीबीआई और बाकी की जो एजेंसीज हैं उनसे बेटर तो नहीं है, राइट? अगर हम होते तो शायद हम वहां पर होते. तो हम ये नहीं डिसाइड कर सकते कि कौन विक्टिम है और कौन क्रिमिनल है या कौन क्या है, राइट? तो बहुत सारी चीजें हमारी लाइफ में है कॉन्सेंट्रेट करने के लिए. तो आप पहली बात तो इन चीजों से शिफ्ट हुई है, और क्योंकि आप ये चीजें नहीं दिखा सकते. जिस दिन आपको जो सुप्रीम कोर्ट डिसाइड करेगा आप उस चीज को एक्सेप्ट करें और उस चीज के साथ चले जाए. उतने ड्यूरेशन में आप थोड़ा शांति लें और अपना जीवन अच्छे से स्पेंड करें. मैं बस इतना बोलना चाहूंगा.
विनय जी,
आई थिंक सुप्रीम कोर्ट जो है उनकी डायरेक्शन जो है इसमें बहुत क्लियर है, और वी शुड ऑल अबाइड बाय इट एंड हैव फेथ इन इट कि जो कोर्ट्स जो डिसाइड करते हैं वो सही होता है, वो ठीक होता है. वो किसी पब्लिक ओपिनियन से बना हुआ नहीं, उनकी जजेस का अपना जो उनकी अपनी जो थॉट्स होती हैं उसके बेसिस पे होता है. तो आई थिंक वी शुड लीव इट टू देम.
Thank you so much everybody for such a invigorating conversation, and I absolutely enjoyed this, and I mean it as genuinely as possible. Thank you Anuj, thank you Naveen, thank you Vinayji for bringing in such unique perspectives and for making it a learning experience for me, might I say that, you know, and I'm sure for our audiences. And yes, to summarize, essentially, you know, use logic, use some rationale, and don't get swayed, you know, by the herd mentality as we know it. Right. Thank you so much. Thank you everybody for being a part of this wonderful conversation. It's been an absolute honor and delight to, you know, have this experience with you, if I might say.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you all of you on behalf of Orange City Literature Fest by SGR Knowledge Foundation. We sincerely express our gratitude towards your acceptance for the session and knowledge shared with us. And I also like to thank the publisher Rupa Publications India, and would also like to acknowledge our radio partner Big FM. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Thank you.
20 years of existence. 2 universities. 23 educational institutes. Offering 137 courses. Dice Only Group of Institutions, a vision beyond.